Hello everyone, I am Sachin Rathod, working as an assistant professor in mechanical engineering department from Walchand of technology Solapur. So today we'll see the numericals on single block or shoe brake. The learning outcome of this session is student will be able to calculate forces on single block or shoe brake. So you can think about this. So why there is a necessity to calculate how much amount of the force will be the get applied on the lever to stop the rotating drum? Okay, you can think about this. Okay, so there is a need to calculate the forces, means how much amount of the force is required for rotating, stopping the rotating drum. So it is easy for designing the length of the levers or how much distance will be kept in between the position of the fulcrums and the center of the disc, or how much distance we have to keep in between the fulcrum position to the frictional lining force. So for that purpose, means ultimately if you are going to design the single shoe brake or single block brake, we require to calculate how much amount of the force is required on the lever to stop the rotating drum. Okay, we will see how to calculate this. So before to going to the numericals, we will see what are the conditions of the position of the block or shoe on the drum. So already we have seen this is a rotating drum. It may be rotates in the clockwise or anti-clockwise direction on which the shoe is placed, and here is a lever is rigidly fixed to this shoe. The fulcrum positions may be along the lines, it may be the below the center points, or it may be the above the frictional lining, and here the P force is applied on this lever. So in that case, the angle of block with the center of the disc, it matters lot. So this angle 2 theta is a angle of the block or the shoe from the center of the disc. So this 2 theta, if 2 theta is less than or equal to the 660 degree, at that times the uniform pressure will get distributed over this contacting surface. And if the angle 2 theta is greater than 60 degree, at that time the maximum pressure will get absorbed at the center of this point and the minimum pressure will get absorbed at the end of this shoe. So for that purpose we have to consider the mu dash, that is the coefficient of friction if angle of the block is more than 60 degree. So the coefficient of friction mu dash is equal to mu, that is the actual coefficient of friction in bracket 4 sine theta divided by 2 theta plus sine of 2 theta. By using this equation, wherever the mu is there, that we can replace with the mu dash. So we have to use this formula if the angle of the block is greater than 60 degree. So by considering this concept, we will see how to solve the numericals. So one numericals I have taken, that is a single block brake is shown in the figure. The diameter of the drum is 250 mm and the angle of the contact is 90 degree. If the operating force of 700 newton is applied at the end of the lever and the coefficient of friction between the drum and the lining is 0.35, determine the torque that may be the transmitted by the block brake. Okay, so we will write the given data, given thing, that the diameter of the drum, that is the D, is equal to 250 mm, is equal to 0.25 meter. Therefore radius of the drum is equal to 0.125 meter. The angle of the contact is 90 degree. So the angle of the contact, this is nothing but the 2 theta. Therefore, 2 theta is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, theta is equal to 45 degree. So, as the angle 2 theta is greater than 60 degree, we have to consider the value of mu dash. Again, they are given the force P is equal to 700 Newton is applied at the end of the line. The coefficient of friction mu is equal to 0.35. We have to calculate the TB value. So, as the angle 2 theta is greater than 60 degree, we have to calculate the value of mu dash. This is a actual coefficient of friction between drum and lining. This is drum and lining. This is the actual coefficient of friction mu. As the angle 2 theta is greater than 60 degree, we have to find out the mu dash value. As the pressure is not going to be distributed uniformly through this block. So, mu dash is equal to mu in bracket 4 sine theta divided by 2 theta plus sine of 2 theta. So, mu is equal to 0.35 in bracket 4 sine 45 divided by 2 into 45 plus sine of 90 degree. So, we have to calculate this. 4 sine 45, that is equal to 2.828 divided by 2 theta, that is 90. That 90, it is in the degree, we have to convert into the radian. So 90 into pi by 180 plus sine 90. So we are getting the answer 2.57079. It is equal to 2.828 divided by answer into 0.35. So we are getting that 0.385. So this is a new coefficient of friction, that as the angle is greater than 60 degree. So now we have to calculate the value of TB. That we are knowing the value of the TB. TB is equal to mu into Rn into the radius of the drum R. So we have to calculate the value of Rn. For that purpose, we have to take the moment about this fulcrum. So that take the moment about fulcrum O. Therefore, 700 into the distance, total distance is 200 plus 250, it is in the mm, so into 0.45 meter, and this rotates in the clockwise direction, only in the same direction of this. So plus ft into this distance 50, that is a 0.05, and this normal reaction, it is opposite, in the opposite, minus rn into this distance 200, that is a 0.2, it is equal to 0. Therefore, we have to calculate the value of Rn. Therefore, 700 into 0.45315 plus ft into 0.5, that is ft is equal to mu Rn, that is we have to consider the value of mu dash into the Rn into the 0.05 minus Rn into 0.2, it is equal to 0. Therefore, so we will solve here. is equal to, you have to take the mu dash is equal to minus mu dash into the Rn into 0.05 plus 0.2 into Rn. So put the value of mu dash, minus 0.385 0.05 into the Rn plus 0.2 Rn, it is equal to, take the Rn term common, so 0.385 into 0.05 minus 0.01925 plus 0.2 is equal to minus answer variating 0.18075 Rn. Therefore Rn is equal to 315 divided by 0.75. Therefore 315 variating the answer 1742.73 newton. So this is the value of Rn. So you have to calculate the TB. Therefore TB is equal to that mu is nothing but the mu dash. The mu dash value is 0.385 into the value of Rn 1742.73 into the radius of the drum, that is a 0.125. It is equal to this value into 0.385 into 0.125. So we are getting 83.869 newton meter. So this is the required answer, that is a braking torque TB is equal to 83.869 newton meter. So like this way you can easily calculate the braking torque acting by the drum. These are my references. Thank you.